Okay, so the last section in chapter 2 is about implicit differentiation. And so first we want to talk about what it means for something to be defined implicitly. So we're pretty used to explicit definitions of functions. That's something like y is equal to 4x plus 8, or sometimes we see it written as f of x is equal to 3x squared minus 2x plus 1, something like that. Explicitly defining this output function here, which is listed on one side of the equation, or the equal sign, with, and the only thing here on the right are the input values, okay? Variables that are inputs. Okay, and so when I say implicitly defined, it is an equation that looks maybe something more like this. There is a relationship between x and y, but I don't have some output equals, so over here, explicit output equals something where I have inputs, right? And over here in an implicit definition, you have outputs and inputs mixed together. There is still an equal sign in these, and sometimes more outputs and inputs on the other side. So, I mean, something completely reasonable to have in this definition is something like this. This is y. Y is still the output here. And x is still the input variable. But now they're mixed up in this way that it's hard to see exactly what y equals in terms of x. Okay? Now, we want to be able to differentiate these things. Being able to define things implicitly is actually very useful. It happens all the time in real life applications. And we want to be able to differentiate this to be able to find how these functions are changing with respect to x. Okay? So, and I'll just make a note, we will base this on the chain rule. And really, I want to just look at some maybe very simple example so that we can. So I just want to differentiate this 3y squared equals 0. Okay? I just have my output here. There's no input, and I could easily solve this. I just want to look at this simple example. Okay? So I have this, and really, in this example, and everywhere that we're going to be talking about y in this section, I should think of y as some function g of x. It is some output function. I just don't know what that is. Okay? And so really, I'm thinking here that this is some function 3 g of x squared is equal to 0. Now let's ignore this equal sign for 1 minute. But I know through the chain rule how to differentiate the left side of this equation. Okay? I use this chain rule. I take the derivative of this outside function, right? I have this outside function, which in this case, f of x is 3x squared, and my inside function is just this g of x. Okay, I don't know what it is, right? So f prime of x is equal to 6x, and g prime is just g prime. Okay? So when I actually take the derivative of this left side, I put, remember, it's, let me remind you. So if my original function is h of x is equal to f of g of x, then h prime of x is f prime of the original inside times g prime. So I'm going to use that here, okay? So in this function, my function on the left, or this left side piece, f is 6x, so I'm going to put 6 here, and then the inside is whatever this g of x is. Right? And then I still have to multiply by g prime of x. That's the derivative of this left side. So here in these steps, I'm going from 3g of x squared, and then I take the derivative, and really I have that equal to 0. I just take the derivative of the right side also. The derivative of 0 is 0. And I get something that looks like this. But I'm just using this g of x as an explicit thing. Really, in my problem, I'm thinking about these as y's. I mean, this is how you'll see it. Y times, and this is probably y prime, is equal to 0. Okay? So this is how I take this derivative. It turns out that you can take it kind of simply like you would. I have to put this extra piece due to the chain rule out here. So let me go through these steps again so that you can see it. Like, this previous was kind of an idea of what was happening. But really, in functionality, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the derivative with respect to y. So I get 6y, just like you would. But then I have to multiply due to the chain rule times the derivative of y. And then I take the derivative of the right side. Okay, so that's how we're going to do the chain rule. Let's do a couple more examples. Oh, so here, this power rule for these for the implicit differentiation looks something like this. And this is the one that I'm using. So the derivative d by dx of y to the nth power is n y to the n minus 1 times y prime. The exact rule that I just used, okay? So let's do an example so that you can kind of see what's happening. Sample, find y prime, we'll work this fully, for 3y cubed minus 2y squared is equal to x, okay? So we'll go ahead and work this problem out. So I take the derivative of 3y cubed, and that's 9y squared, and then I have to multiply by y prime, right, this chain rule, minus 4y, also times y prime, and then the derivative of x with respect to x is just 1. Okay, now I want to find y prime. So here, let me identify, here's my y prime, and here's my y prime. It's in both these things, so I'm going to factor it out. Y prime times 9y squared minus 4y is equal to 1. To get it by itself, I divide both sides by this piece that's inside here. There. Okay. This is also defined implicitly. That's a y prime. Implicitly in terms of y. And you can have x's there too. Okay. But the idea is to try and get y prime by itself. Okay. So let's try one more example. Find y prime. For, and this is just a bigger example of the one that we just did, so that you can see it as kind of these problems grow, but still polynomials. Find y prime, and then we'll find it at a point, okay? So again, this is 9y squared times y prime minus 4y times y prime plus 20x cubed minus 1 equals 0. Okay? Now, I identify the piece that I want to get by itself. That's y prime right here. Okay? These other pieces I need to move over somehow. So the first thing that I'm going to do is move over the pieces that have nothing to do with y prime. So I'll do that. 9y squared times y prime minus 4y times y prime is equal to negative 20x cubed plus 1. Okay. Now again, I'll use this trick. Factor out the y prime. I'm left with 9y squared minus 4y. There we go. And then divide. So I get y prime is equal to negative 20x cubed plus 1 over 9y squared minus 4y. And it looks like that. Now, if I want to find y prime at a point, let's say at the point 2, 3, this is an xy point that I'm given implicitly. And I can plug that into this derivative because I have x's and y's there. So I get y prime is equal to negative 20. I plug in x, 2 cubed plus 1 divided by 9. And then I plug in 3 for y squared minus 4 times 3. Okay, let me get my calculator and we'll figure out what that is. So in the numerator, I get negative 159. In the denominator, I get 9 times 9 minus 12 over 69. Okay? Okay, so this is the basics of implicit differentiation and at a point. I'm going to do a couple of separate videos on where we see the product rule come into play, where we see the chain rule come into play, and the quotient rule, so you can kind of see examples of those in this context. But let me know if you have any questions.